Hey, hi, hello guys, Nightmare in a Line here, back with another video. Today is going to be the first video of a new series I have created for this channel called The Greeks, The Myths, The Legends. With this, I will be going over and discussing different Greek myths and what I find interesting, and hopefully you find it interesting too. I am very excited to start this series, as it has been a hobby of mine to look into Greek mythology. So without further ado, let's get to it. Today's myth that we are going to be exploring is going to be the Greek myth and love story between Poseidon, king of the seas, and his wife Amphitrite, the sea nymph or nereid. But there's also another way to say her name, which is Amphitrite, but I say Amphitrite. If you want to hear about my version for it, for my comic that is going to be releasing at some point, please stick through the video to the end. Who is Poseidon? Poseidon is the Greek god of the seas, who's very known and popular with the Greeks. I believe that sailors, before going out to sea, would pray to Poseidon for a safe voyage. Poseidon was known as the creator of horses and ruled over storms, floods, and earthquakes. He was called the savior of sailors, avoider of earthquakes, tamer of horses, and leader of the nymphs. Throughout a whole lot of Greek mythology, it is known that most of the popular gods usually had some anger issues, and that included Poseidon, and this fact actually will contribute to the myth we will be talking about today. Who is Amphitrite? So, first we are going to start with what a nereid is. So, nereids are known as sea nymphs that were born from the Greek titan Nereus, known as the Old Man of the Sea, and Doris, the Oceanid. She is also a type of sea nymph or an ocean nymph. There are multiple different types of nymphs, sisters that Doris has, but that's all very complicated. They reside in the Aegean Sea, if there are any Greeks that are listening to this, I am so sorry, I must have said that wrong. And I found this from information from the Homeric passages. The name Nereid meant daughter of Nereus and was taken from the Greek word neros, which means wet. In total, there are 50 Nereids, from what I can assume. They help take care and look after the sea. Nereids were also known to help aid sailors out of storms while in the sea. Now on to Amphitrite. She is the eldest of the 50 Nereids and was said to have given birth to seals and dolphins within my research. She was at first noted as an important goddess in Greek mythology because she and other very important Greek gods were there at the birth of Apollo, but she slowly, over time, just became the personification of sea in poems. Amphitrite is known as a kind and level-headed goddess of the sea, who balances out her husband Poseidon. So, I have found about the same myth, but it has two different ways it ends, so I will be going through the myth until it splits off, and I will separate the two for both sides of it. During a time of loneliness and anger, Poseidon had created several very strong storms that were so strong that they united the heavens and the sea. Once Poseidon realized that he was being too angsty, he thought the best way to fix the problem was to find himself a wife, instead of some anger management. As he was searching and most likely trying to get into some woman's pants, well, togas, I guess, different time, he went to the island of Naxos, I probably said that wrong, it's Greek as well, and found Amphitrite and her sisters, the Nereids, dancing around a bonfire. When the god Poseidon saw Amphitrite, it was like love at first sight. Yet, when he tried to make her his wife, she wanted nothing to do with him. Amphitrite told him no, and that she did not want to give up her life as a virgin sea nymph with her sisters. Here's where the myth splits. She either ran off and hid in the Atlas Mountains, which is understandable knowing the Greek gods, and Poseidon didn't want to give up that easily, so he sent Delphinus, the king of the dolphins, who was known to be very good at persuasion or had a golden tongue, I believe, to convince our goddess. After weeks of searching, Delphus found Amphitrite in the Atlas Mountains, and Amphitrite was drawn to the lovely creature Delphus and listened to what he had to say. He told our goddess that if she married Poseidon, that there would be harmony and peace in the sea and joy to everyone. After he successfully persuaded Amphitrite to become Poseidon's bride, Delphus was rewarded by receiving his very own constellation of his image in the sky. The second way it went, which isn't as in-depth, was that Poseidon took Amphitrite to her father, Nereus, and they forced her to marry Poseidon, but I honestly like the dolphin one better. After they married, Amphitrite became the queen of the sea, but in Greek mythology, Poseidon, of course, didn't stay true to her and went back to his cheating ways. With that, I will add in this fun little myth I found in the research that was caused because of Poseidon's cheating. It is the story of Scala. I don't know if I'm saying that right. The monster with 12 arms and 6 mouths. Originally, Scala was a beautiful sea nymph that Poseidon was having affairs with. Amphitrite had just been sucking up and dealing with all of Poseidon's cheating, but she became to become jealous and annoyed. During this time, the newest fling was Scala, as we know, who Poseidon was absolutely entranced with. So, one day, filled with jealousy, our goddess Amphitrite tossed magical herbs into Scala's bath, making Scala change into a hideous monster with 12 arms and 6 mouths. Scala then spent her days as a monster living in a cave, eating sailors that she grabbed with her long arms, and Amphitrite left satisfied. As you might know, if you keep regular tabs with me, you will know that I have been hinting to a comic in the making for a while. Well, this comic is actually based on this very myth we're talking about today, which I figured was best fit to be the first of the series, The Greeks, the Myth, the Legends. But I put a little twist on the myth so that it's comic ready. So let me share with you the brief plot of this story. One day, Poseidon stumbles upon Amphitrite, our goddess as we know, and immediately falls in love with her. After trying to win her hand twice and being shot down by Amphitrite, she finally agrees to get to know Poseidon for a year, and if she does not feel the same way as he does at the end of the year, he must leave her and never speak to her again. After agreeing to this deal, they spend some time to get to know each other and her family. Amphitrite accidentally runs into Oceanus, the titan of the sea, which is kind of her grandfather, but Greek mythology is weird, while trying to find one of her sisters. Oceanus falls obsessively in love with Amphitrite and vows to have her as his own. Very familiar, isn't it? After a bit of watching or stalking, he finds out that Amphitrite and Poseidon were close and sees that Poseidon is in love with her, and he might think she's fallen for him as well. Oceanus becomes absolutely furious and decides to kidnap Amphitrite and hold her against his will until she will agree to marry him. Poseidon tries to fight him but does not succeed and almost dies. Pontus, our primordial god of the sea, who is the father to all of them, finds Poseidon and brings him back to health and trains him as fast as possible to save his love. Once Poseidon is done training and is stronger, he goes to seek out Oceanus again. Oceanus had tried to force Amphitrite to marry him, but when she refused the final time, Oceanus becomes furious and tries to kill Amphitrite. The whole, if I can't have you, no one can kind of thing. Poseidon finds Oceanus and they fight once more, but this time Hermes passes by and sees the fight and calls for the help from some of the other gods while an epic battle scene takes place. Oceanus is defeated by Poseidon and the gods lock away Oceanus for the rest of time with the other titans. Poseidon and Amphitrite confess their love, da 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 da, everyone lives happily ever after. And that's the plot of my comic, I guess. That's how it's going to go, if that interests you. I will be putting a bit more stuff out for the comic soon. I just gotta have more ready. Anyways, that's all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the very first episode of The Greeks, The Myths, The Legends. I will definitely be having a lot of fun with this series. If you know any Greek myths that you want me to cover, feel free to comment it down below. If you want to see more of my art and stuff for the comic, please check out my Linktree in the description down below. And also, if you want behind-the-scenes access to my comic and other things like that, you can check out my Patreon for the comic. If you want to talk to me more outside of the comment section, feel free to check out my Discord. There we'll have discussions and I can get the motivation from you guys to work on the comic. Anyways, that's all for now. Please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you don't miss another The Greeks, The Myths, The Legends episode, and my live streams, which I do every single Sunday at 12 o'clock CST. Make sure to stay hydrated, happy, and safe, and have a wonderful day. Bye! Under this love, 'cause with those nectar lips and amber